I am supposed to have a phone coming in the mail tomorrow, Lord willing. I have to see if it will work out. But my phone is officially dead, basically. The guts are hanging out and everything. But I'm filming on it. So, I thought I would show you guys my holiday look. I went to a Christmas party at the church today. I went to Christmas caroling afterwards, and I just thought I would give you guys a little walkthrough into how I achieved this look. And most of my makeup was picked out by my best friend Divine. She has been teaching me makeup for a couple years. She's very talented. She's an artist like I am. We love to draw and we love to do artistic things, and she's been teaching me how to work with like my natural features. Starting off, I used this e.l.f. concealer. It's e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer Matte Finish. And I got this really cheap at a yard sale. My favorite concealer is NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop. But it is almost completely run out. And when I went to the store, it was $10. I've had to replace my microwave, my car, and my cell phone in the last month. So I cannot afford these like that currently. So I decided to use this instead. The only issue that I have with this concealer is that it is very pale, which works okay right now, but in the summer, it did not look normal. It made me look really washed out and kind of sick in a way. But right now, it's pretty close match to my neck, I would say, when it's combined with the foundation. I just put a little bit in some trouble areas. They're a little bit redder. I put some on my nose because my nose is always red, pretty much always. And a little bit on my chin. I did some little triangles under my eyes, and I used some around my eyebrows after I did my eyebrows to clean it up. And it worked pretty good. And I used this ColourPop Pretty Fresh in light 33C. And this stuff works really good for me. Divine and I looked for a long time to find a close match, and this brand really pulled through for us. We did try some that did not, and we had to make some returns. But yeah, I've had that one since last year. And then Divine's been trying to get me to use moisturizing makeup instead of things that are going to dry me out or make me look dry. She always goes for the dewy or the moisturized. That's why we have the liquid. And then I got this this cream blush that I really like, and it's called Blush Balm Provocative Petal. I don't remember the name of the brand. If you guys know, you might help me out. I really like it. And then I just use this, just like that, and then getting in like the creases and stuff. I said, I'm learning, guys, but I'm kind of just sharing with you guys. I got this Anastasia tinted brow gel, and I really like this because it skips a step, especially when I'm in a hurry, kind of like I was this morning getting ready to go to church. And instead of using the brow pencil and the brow gel, I just used this tinted gel. And it's in a light brown. I really love this brand that Divine got me hooked on. The one thing about this, the tinted gel is it's a little bit messier than the other method, so I have to definitely clean it up with the concealer afterwards. I'm all about having like the natural eyebrows. I don't like them to look painted on. That's why I keep them a little bit bigger than some, and I don't do extreme arches. I found out that doesn't really suit my face, and I just, yeah, I like that natural look, but I also like it to look super clean, like when I'm going to, like, events, and during the week, I don't care. Like, I honestly don't. I might wear, like, a tinted chapstick, and I'm all about cleaning and moisturizing my skin and keeping it healthy, because it's not healthy to wear makeup on it all the time, for sure. And I might just wear a little bit of makeup here and there, but most of the time, I just keep a clean face, and then on the weekends, especially if I have somewhere important to go, I like to kind of go all out. And, oh, on the eyes, my stuff fell. Okay, so I got this Hard Candy glitter shadow set years ago. I think it was in 2018, and I just used it every once in a while. It's kind of costing me, but I thought it was perfect for a Christmas party, and this time I used the pink. I'm normally drawn to like the silver or the white. I do like the blue because blue is my favorite color, but blue is a little bit much for me. I've been noticing that I really like white and pink around my eyes. I want my eyes to look as big and beautiful as possible, and I am not about anything dark that's gonna make my eyes look narrower. Only darkness from my eyes right now is the mascara, and I've seen some clear mascara, and I'm really thinking about getting that, but I do like that. I do like how it makes my eyes bigger. I have very long eyelashes, but they don't, like, naturally curl, so I like to do that. I use that, and then underneath it, I used, this stuff right here, called Happening. This is Smoke and Mirrors Soft Glam. I got this at a yard sale. When I got it, it was not even used. And I usually like the light, shimmery pink colors around my eyes. But I use that as a base to go under the glitter. I guess to just kind of have it to have a little bit more substance instead of just glitter. So there would still be something there, you know, when the glitter kind of spread everywhere like it does. And then I Sky High and Lash Paradise. Okay. That, the Sky High is Maybelline. And I can't remember what Lash Paradise is at the moment. But, I use the Sky High for length and the Lash Paradise for volume, which I don't normally go to the extent of using both, but because it's an event, I decided to use both. I was going to a Christmas party and Christmas caroling, so I wanted to look super cute. This lip liner, and I just traced and then colored in the whole lips to give my lip gloss a good base to hold on to. And I normally go for a darker lip, but today I wanted to go for like just a really kind of angelic look, all rosy and light. I got this NYX Tea and Cookies, and it's really soft and pretty. The one I usually use is the NYX Nutmeg, and on top I used the NYX Butter Gloss. And it looks really nice with the nutmeg too. It just makes it look a little bit darker, a darker undertone to it. But I usually use the NYX Nutmeg and the like this, or I will use like a burgundy lipstick. And when I went to buy a replacement for the Nutmeg, because it's running low, they didn't have any of it. So I looked at the different colors and I was like, should I go darker? Should I go lighter? And I decided to try lighter. And I really like the results of that. I think this would be great for like when I want to dress as an angel again. And make it last longer, I used Make It Last Dewy by Milani. It's supposed to be 16 hour wear, and I like that it's dewy, that it gives that dewy look. It's not looking dried out, and I really I like it. It feels nice and I like it. But today I did have some wear, and I did have to touch up a little bit because I kept like blowing my nose, so I had like patchiness going on here, and then of course, you know, you eat and stuff, so I had to do that too. But I hope you guys all have a blessed day, and I don't know if you guys are interested in this or not, but I would do a whole tutorial, honestly, if I had time sometime, and if I had a better working camera. But tell me if you guys be interested, and I am interested in seeing what you guys share as well. I'm thinking about getting back into watching makeup tutorial videos. I used to watch them, and I used to